I blame you, God. I blame you. If I were to be God, I would do better than you. I would do better than you.
In the name of Jesus, you destroy us from the pit of hell.
We did not come for you. We came for her. Depart or die.
Yeah, wait. And you can't touch me, for I bear in my body the marks of the Lord Jesus.
We can see the marks, but I'll see that again.
So what do you want?
I want this woman.
You can't have this woman.
Why?
Give to Caesar what belongs to Caesar.
What belongs to Caesar?
She belongs to Caesar.
She belongs to God.
This is a rebellious altar. A lawful captive, a slave, and a filthy servant.
This is a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, an holy nation, a peculiar people. First Peter 2 now.
Is she not a sinner?
No, she is righteous.
According to Romans 3:23, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God.
And being justified freely by his grace through the redemption which is in Christ Jesus, whom God set forth to be a propitiation by his blood through faith. He demonstrates his righteousness because in God's forbearance, Jesus passed over the sins which were previously committed.
Then where is your faith? You talk about righteousness without faith? For what says the scripture? Romans 4:3, Abraham believed God and it was counted unto him for righteousness. Where is your faith?
Where is your faith? The just shall live by faith.
Through faith, Sarah received strength to conceive and was delivered of a child when she was past age. Hebrews 11:11. Where is your faith?
Where is your faith?
James 1:2, count it all joy when you fall into diverse temptation, knowing this that the trying of your faith worketh patience. But where is the faith?
From one generation. I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. How many Christians in this generation can boldly say this? Faithless Christians.
Depart! Let her kill herself. God, you understand. Her faith is little.
Then I join my faith with her faith. Proverbs 27 verse 17. Iron sharpeneth iron.
She has no faith at all.
Not all Christians are given the gift of faith. 1 Corinthians 12:9.
Romans 6:23. The wages of sin is death.
But the free gift of God is eternal life through Christ Jesus our Lord.
You are God's enemy.
Romans 5:10. But he has made us his friends through the death of his son. And much more then, having been justified freely by his blood, we are saved from God's wrath through Jesus.
Shut up! You talk too much. Shut up! What did he say? That is the language they use above in order to confuse us down here. And your God did not spare our master the devil when he rebelled against him. This woman should suffer the same fate.
Our case is different. For we are the apple of God's eyes. Even your master, the devil, knows better.
Good. Let's talk about the devil.
I don't discuss the devil. He is not a factor. Let's talk about Jesus.
No.
And the power of his salvation. The first begotten of the dead. The resurrection and the life. And the head of all principalities. As I call upon Jesus, the author and the finisher of my faith. And by faith, I command you to lose your grip. In the name of Jesus.
Ah! You have taken our captive.
We command the ground where you stand to see.
No! On Christ the solid rock I stand. Whosoever did get a pit shall forget it.
Break it in the papa. We command the great me from Hades to blind your way.
They that trust in the Lord shall be as Mount Zion that cannot be moved, but abide it forever. Shut up! I am still talking. And upon that Mount Zion, there shall be deliverance, and there shall be holiness, and the house of Jacob shall possess their possession, just as it was in the days of Elijah. I command fire from above. Jehovah the consuming fire, send down your fire. They shall be as double. The fire shall burn them. They shall not deliver themselves from the power of the flame.
Hebrews 12:29. For our God is a consuming fire.
Fire of the Holy Ghost. Fire of the Holy Ghost. Fire of the Holy Ghost.
Get out.
In the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Father, according to your word, you will arise and have mercy upon Zion, for the time to favor her. Yes, the set time has come. Honor your word, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Where am I? Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch. that taught my heart to fear. And in grace, my feet believed. How precious did that grace appear.